Hi everyone, and welcome to my lounge room. Around 6 years ago, I set about advancing the technology in my lounge room by voice controlling all of the electronics and entertainment equipment in the room. In the early days, I prototyped a number of ideas which proved to me I was onto something good, so I pursued it. Since then, I've been working away steadily to turn my ideas into a reality. It is an open system where I have complete control of what the system is capable of, the brands I use, and the entertainment I have access to, all without any ongoing subscription fees and minimal privacy concerns. All of the processing is done in-house, enabling all the commands to be executed instantly. It's a long-term solution. While it is not yet perfect, it is simple, versatile, and intuitive, made possible by a great deal of technology I have not seen elsewhere. The first step to make this happen was to modify the room to make it suitable, not only for the technology, but for my family to hang out. As I was putting in an extension, it was simple to put in the HDMI, USB, speaker, and networking cables for all these projects and other projects around the house. To get some of the basics out of the way, I chose to paint the wall black to make the borders of the television blend into the wall. My speakers, while cheap, sound their best as they are set up in the recommended Dolby Surround placement. The room looks fairly void of technology beyond the screen and speakers, but this is far from the case. All of the equipment that does not need to be seen or heard is hidden. This also has the benefit of silencing the lights and fans which are so abundant in modern technology. The whole room is controlled by one computer tucked away in the cupboard. The computer looks after everything as it is used for games, movies, TV, music, pictures, videos, and for controlling all the various appliances in the room. There are no standalone set-top boxes or DVD players. Being computer-driven, it has been possible to control everything in the room with my gadget and my voice, which in turn has made access to all my entertainment almost instant. There are many unique components in the room which have made the room simple to control, as well as making the voice control practical. First off, we have my remote, which is accessible on entry to the room and provides a very quick way of accessing the entertainment I want to access. The 10-foot interfaces that were designed to be viewed from 10 feet away, such as Windows Media Center, are also ideally suited to work as touch interfaces. I've built onto this, designing my own minimalist interface to provide touch control to launch any program, to control the appliances, and to quickly control the media center. It is a single press to show just about anything up on the big screen. So for example, if I launch the media center, not only does Windows Media Center open, the system decides if the TV and stereo need to be turned on. While this is fast and simple, there is a quicker way. I have also placed a microphone in the ceiling, which gives the system reliable voice control. This is a high-quality Shure Boundary Condenser microphone. While you can get voice control to work with a cheap microphone, the results are more reliable using a microphone of higher quality. By combining this with a Roland OctoCapture USB audio interface, I've been able to add a noise gate to filter out background noise, and a compressor to level out the signal volume. This microphone also has a cardioid polar pattern, which means the microphone will target the people in the chairs. While this may sound very technical, the right equipment makes all the difference. The voice control is not always listening like many other systems. It is only listening when I tell it to. Because of this, I needed a clear indicator so that I knew when the system was listening for commands. So I added some lights above the TV to show what is happening. It is not practical to use the TV for this job, as a great number of commands can be executed without turning the TV on. It works much the same way as a radio's on-air light. It turns on when voice control is turned on, flashes when a command is accepted, and counts down when a command can optionally have follow-up commands. An example of this is skip. Lastly and of greatest value is the use of a trigger to activate voice control. I refer to this as my gadget. The role of my gadget is to prepare the environment to receive voice commands. This is done by dropping the volume of what is being played in the room, and even momentarily turning off noisy appliances if needed. This allows for the computer to receive a clear command without being confused by other noises it hears, as well as allowing me to speak at a comfortable volume to issue the commands, without the need to raise my voice. Without this, watching TV at a volume higher than a natural talking volume makes it near impossible for a microphone to know what to listen to, causing the system to fail. My gadget solves this problem. Pressing my gadget can also be used to pause, play, select, and resume the playback of media without the need of a voice command. If that's not enough, it is used to tell the system which room and therefore which microphone to use, as well as telling the system who is using it, which allows for possible customizations for different users in the home. Who would have thought one button could do so much? My gadget can be used in many forms. To start off with is my original gadget, which is based on a TV Bigon kit. By using infrared, all the systems throughout the house can be controlled with my gadget, no matter which room I am in. Infrared is the only technology that does not see through walls. This is a great advantage which will become clearer in future videos. As well as this, I've reprogrammed a button on the game controllers to trigger the voice control for when playing games. I've also created a number of triggers on my phone's home screen to trigger the voice control in the various rooms. And finally, I've installed a button in the lounge chairs. These arcade buttons are the most accessible option for when watching TV. They are always at my fingertips. So long as I am in a room with this technology built in, at the press of any of these triggers, I gain full control of all the media and appliances throughout the house. Videos. Select. Select. Down 4. Volume 30. Replay. Music. Roll right. Faster. Faster. Stop. Down 2. Right 6. Move left. Volume 20. Skip. This was close to love and affection. This was close. Fallout 4. Exit. I'm done. So how does it all work? The computer runs Windows 7. The three programs used to control the system are Event Ghost to control the devices, Windows Speech Recognition macros to take in the voice commands, and an Auto Hotkey script which acts as the brain between the two. This system will do anything I program it to do, and I am not limited by any restrictions applied to commercial products due to licensing or closed systems. The system does everything I currently want it to do. As the years go on, the only upgrades I will need to do are to the computer to play newer games. If there were new technology on the market that interested me, for the most part, I can plug it in and add that functionality easily. The speed at which technology is evolving is slowing. Much of the technology coming to the market isn't necessarily an improvement on what was possible in the past, but a different way of doing things, often not in the consumer's interest, nor looking to be compatible with future technology. This system, on the other hand, I believe every home with a TV will have at least some of these ideas in place. I can't think of any other way to gain so much immediate control of the technology throughout the house. I plan over the coming months to show you how you can put this technology in your own home. If I haven't sold you yet on the benefits of the system, you may be interested to see how this technology can be incorporated into other parts of the house. There are a number of things this system could do that I had not foreseen, completely useful and reliable features that my family use every day. So please visit inspectmygadget.com over the coming months to see if this technology is of interest to you.